Today's video is going to be on peace of mind during shit hits the fan. Everyone is in their mind is going to want to panic because everything that they knew in their entire life is normal is now altered or gone. Now, if you're a prepper like I am, you may have some of the things you see on the table now, which are just kind of a sample of basic things. We have some rice, we have some brown sugar, we've got some beans for protein, we even have some granola in there with a little powdered milk. So we just add water, give it thorough stirring, and then stir it again with some purified water, not just something out of a nasty lake. And we can only have something that resembles the breakfast of old. Now, what I would like to insert into this discussion is not just are we prepping for survival, but we also want to take the edge off of survival. So we have some things to remind us of the days of old, whether it's for our soul, our peace of mind, etc., because it's going to be hard, harder than I can possibly explain, harder than I myself can even imagine. And so what I want to make as a suggestion is two different categories of things that might make life after shit hits the fan better than just surviving. Maybe not thriving, but taking the edge off the survival. I'm going to show you a couple of examples of things that I've purchased for myself. And these sorts of things will vary on your personal taste and preferences. As an example, here I have a can of honey-coated banana slices. Okay, I like bananas. Okay, there's one prep that I can do to treat myself to something sweet. It's a treat. It's not a meal. It's not going to help my rice taste better, but it is a treat for me, and it's sweet to remind me of the days of, oh, when we used to have candy, you know, things like that. Let me give you another example of something that's not required for survival, but would be kind of a nice treat. Anybody recognize something like this? Yeah, good old coffee. Remember when you used to get up in the morning and just hit a button, and 5 minutes later you had that hot coffee, maybe even put in a little cream, a little sugar, which means you might want to prep for sugar. That is an option because you can make coffee in a grid down situation. It's no longer gone forever. But if you don't have any coffee, then you're putting yourself at a detriment. And again, we're trying to help support the psyche, the soul, whatever you want to call it, in a grid down, shit hits the fan situation. I have another example here, which is also good for no matter whether you're a child or an adult, and that's simply hot chocolate. And this is not hot chocolate specifically out of the local grocery store. This is something that's meant to hold for 15 years. And I have, you know, these are just samples of what I have. But being able to, you know, have a cup of hot chocolate at the end of a long day can really help the edge off of what is really physically and emotionally extremely straining. Now I got the guy coming by to cut the grass just in time. Isn't that wonderful? Well, hopefully he doesn't show up too much in the audio, but I wouldn't be surprised. So anyway, I'm going to cut here, and then we'll wait till he's done. All right, the next category is something that would bring you peace of mind, peace of soul, if you believe in a higher power, a connection with that power, your God, that sort of thing. So it can be something, a book of poems. It can be inspirational prayers or statements of the day. It can also be more traditional things. Let me give out an example here. The Bible, the Christian Bible. I think that's a great place to look for inspiration in getting through difficult times. You know, I'm not going to, you know, if you're not Christian, but don't necessarily have a belief, I think it's something to at least evaluate if you think you have a reasonably open mind. Yes, it's divided into two parts, kind of what I'll call an old school part, and what I'll call a new school part, kind of the Old Testimony and the New Testimony. But you're going to have great times of boredom in addition to times of mental strife. And these are things that can possibly bring you solace in addition to fellow humans. to give you inspiration simply to make it through that moment, let alone make it through the day. But I also like to throw out one other thing. Don't be shocked. Yes, that is a copy of the Quran. Whether it's a book of poems or of inspirational prayers, there is sources of solace all around us. All we have to do is look. It doesn't necessarily mean you need to believe in Allah or anything like that. Nor if you are Islam, it doesn't mean that you can't read the Bible and find something inspirational out of there to bring you solace, peace of mind, to help do better than just survive, but also to remember your humanity. Because that's the only thing that makes us any different than the wild beast, is our humanity that I believe God gave us. You may not believe that, that's okay, that happens to be my belief, but I would assume that you believe that we all are capable of having aspects of humanity. And these are just ways to keep us focused on, so we don't lose ourselves on that new road as it sprang up before us out of nowhere. So at this point, again, I just wanted to focus on kind of two different categories of prepping that sometimes don't necessarily get highlighted. It doesn't have to just be, you know, beans and rice, you know, till the end of time. You don't want to just survive. You also want to be able to mentally survive, emotionally survive, still be a good parent, still be a good citizen of the world. You know, the world will be very different. I can't describe to you how it will be. All I know is that it will be extremely different than it is today in a very unpredictable way. So that's my two cents for today. Simply don't forget some stuff for your peace of soul and mind. So thank you and be prepared.